Hey guys, Silver Perez here, and welcome to today's video. In this video, I'm going to be talking about the end of Google Ads average position. And if you're not familiar, back in February of 2019, earlier this year, Google announced that they will be sunsetting the average position metric that will only be available until September 2019 of this year. But with the death of average position, Google has given life to new metrics that can better allow us to understand how our ads are showing on the search results page. Now, with this video, I really want to get into showing you and showcasing you live examples on why the Google Ads average position metric is flawed, in my opinion, and why these new metrics Google is implementing are very good and very solid, and how we can go ahead and better understand and utilize these new metrics for optimizing our accounts and realizing the vast majority of potential that we have been leaving on the table in these prior years by not having better position metrics to base our ads. So let's go ahead and get started and hop into a live account and let's do this. All right, let's first get into why the average position metric is flawed and why Google is rolling out the changes that they are. So first and foremost, let's go ahead and look at average position. So all average position is, it's just exactly what it sounds like. It's the, on average, what position your ad is showing up in. But there's a difference between position and location. Just because your ad is showing in the second spot doesn't mean it's the second spot of the top of the page. In one of the top three ads, it could be the second spot of the bottom of the page. So right, that in itself is already a huge flaw because it doesn't give us context to the location. So the way we remedy that with average position is we segment. So we would segment with top versus other, and then this would give us a better understanding of is how our ads are performing based on location. So for example, right here, Google search top, this tells us where our ads are in the top three spots, how they're performing on average. So for example, our average position in the top spot is about 2. And then other, meaning the bottom of the page, it's about 3.7. And then from there, we can get a better understanding of how we're performing from both locations. But there's a huge gap with this. And that's the fact that, okay, great. On the top position, our ad is showing on average on the second spot. But this doesn't tell us at all how often our ad is showing in the top location. All it's saying is on average, when we are in the top, we're in that second spot. But what percentage of the time are we actually in the top? And that's what average position seriously lacks. And that's why Google is going to be implementing these new metrics. And they created these new metrics for us to use that are percentage based, and they are impression share metrics. So now that we understand why Google is doing what they're doing, let's go ahead and get into these new metrics so you can better understand them and be prepared by September by optimizing your accounts with these new metrics. All right, so to find these new metrics Google is rolling out, just go ahead and click on your columns tab, click on modify columns, and then under competitive metrics, this is where you're gonna find all these new metrics. So the new metrics Google is rolling out is search top impression share, search absolute top impression share, and then last but not least, click share. These are the three new metrics that Google has released so that we can combat the death of average position. So just go ahead and click apply. And then now let's go ahead and get into what each one of these things do. So for example, let's start off with search top impression share. So search top impression share, this tells us what percentage of the time our ads are in the, at least in the one of the three top ad spots. So when the Google search results page, you have three ads at the top, three ads at the bottom. So search top impression share is going to give us a percentage of how often our ads are located within those one of those top three positions. Then search absolute top impression share is going to give us a percentage of what percentage of the time is our ad in that number one position. So we are in the absolute top, the number one spot. And then the last metric is click share. So click share gives us a percentage of all the potential keywords in our account, all the potential clicks that we could receive based on our targeting and our keywords and all that good stuff. What percentage of the market are we receiving, right? So the same way you have market share, what percentage of the market you're dominating with Google Ads and click share, what percentage of the clicks that are available to you based on your keywords and targeting are you actually receiving? So these three new metrics are going to allow us to have such a better understanding in terms of how competitive we are in the marketplace and what percentage of the marketplace we're actually receiving. So from an optimization standpoint, from a reporting standpoint, if in the case that you realize, hey, guess what? We're only showing up in one of the top three locations 31% of the time, that should be a red flag to you from an optimization standpoint that maybe you need to work on improving your quality scores so you can get your ad rank higher, or maybe you need to adjust your max cost per click bid, or maybe your bid strategy is suffocating your bid prices and they're setting your bids too low if you're using an automated bid strategy. So all these things kind of come into play, or maybe you need to test your ads more often to increase your click-through rate, or right, use ad extensions. So these metrics can give us a better understanding of how competitive we are and how much more improvement we have available for our accounts. Because a lot of the times we can think that our campaign is scaled and we've reached, especially with search campaigns, that we've reached all the potential that we can for our keywords and our targeting. But with these competitive metrics, we can really understand of how much of the market we actually are dominating. And then from a reporting standpoint, you can report to your client, last month we were 31% of the time in one of the top three positions. And now this month we are 40% of the time in one of the top three positions. So that's another metric you can add to your reporting to show your client the great work you're doing, or for yourself as a business owner to just manage your account if you're doing this internally yourself. So that's gonna be it for this video. Let me know your thoughts on average position. Are you for this change? Are you against this change? Let me know your thoughts. And I advise each and every one of you watching this video to go into your account and start playing with these new metrics, get comfortable with them. Don't wait until September and do a side-by-side comparison of your average position versus these new metrics so you can better understand them and see the impact that these new metrics have. So that's it. Go ahead and follow along and subscribe to this channel if you got some value from this. I create new content every week, and I'll see you next time. Take care.